elevator.
Okay, here we are. This is the first film of the Water's Edge weekend, the 55th wedding anniversary for Max and Mollie. Unfortunately, they couldn't make it, so we're celebrating in absentia. Yeah, and there's Mr. Trell, who just came up. And there's Mr. Trell.
Gail.
We had that room
when
we came in.
Robert. Yes, Stephen. Just say a few words.
Okay, Stephen, it's 5:06. We have to be ready in 50 minutes.
In 15?
15.
5:00? What can we wait?
Got a whole hour?
The line was busy.
We can wait. The line was busy.
It's Uncle Franklin. He's playing bartender this weekend.
Did you get that? That was hello, everybody. I'd like you to know that Sal Siskin is going to be here. That is the brother of my mother. Tuna!
Just walked in for his,
We've been at the bar
all day.
Since, where do you want to start?
Yeah, Tom.
We'll start with you, Steve, and then we'll go around.
Thank you.
kind of stuffing?
It's a seafood stuffing, same as a stuffed shrimp.
With stuffed shrimp?
Well, you have it boiled?
No, boiled. I'll have it with the shrimp.
Stuffed.
Yeah.
Stuffed.
Yeah.
A pound and a half?
Pound and a half. And I'll have the steaming.
Right. I mean,
there could
be the smoothie is for Jeffrey, so he can see that everyone is here.
Joy, I mean, you've worked, so you know how nice it is to have summer off. Not like you've been.
No, I'm not letting cameras come in. No, please. Stop the interview.
Don't put your hair in
now. Huh? It's too late.
That's a paparazzi.
You know what you want to do?
I have a lot of hair in my eye every night.
My first choice is to see. I'll go to the front. I'll see you. Clam charter.
Frank, I'll hear your dance. Frank met our bus person. Here, give these back to Frank.
Well, I have yours.
Oh, but I need those, yeah, because I have my room. Why do we have a wheel in here?
Julie's back.
What is she doing on my phone? Okay, Daryl, you like the camera, huh?
Yes. Dad, we ought to get one of these.
Now, you can borrow this anytime you go to the Cayman Islands, and I'll take the pictures for you.
Okay.
Are you going out tonight? Where are you going?
You don't have any sweat. You have jeans.
Oh, it's not that cold, though. It's nice out there.
We're in the water.
You're going in the water?
No.
Where's the tripod?
Julie, the tripod doesn't work that well. You know that.
Well, Julian, do you want to go with Julie and Heather?
For where?
To the beach.
Okay.
Well, you better go now.
Yeah, this would be a long switch for it.
Peskin.
Corey's
yeah,
mother.
Yeah, Peskin.
Mrs. Peskin.
And my grandmother's mother were sisters.
There's too much of a gap
Mary?
There.
What do you mean? That's not a gap. Close.
Yeah, my grandmother is the same
Mrs.
age as Corey. My grandmother is the same age as Warren
yeah.
Beth.
Oh, okay.
Oh, but
their mother.
Marriage. Uh-oh.
No. Their mother.
Da, 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 da.
Called insects.
Insects, that's where they get the word.
You mean you and Daddy are
from the insects? That's wrong.
The other side of the family.
Uncle Leah.
I
heard
it's called
insects.
No, it's wrong.
Oh, cool.
But that's why he put
that. Who is the Max Trell? Who is the writer?
Lisa.
It's both my
film
writers.
That
was
great.
Oh,
Sophie has two children. Max and Marie. I'll tell you a story about that. Okay? Very funny story. I was in Bridgeport about, I don't know, 6 years ago. And I was in one of those discount places, Warner. So I was standing in line behind a woman and having nothing to do. I was kind of watching her write her name on her check. I see she's writing Renee Trell. I mean, Trell is uncommon enough. Renee Trell. Who are you, lady? So I look at her and I said, excuse me, I'm not one to ignore this. I said, excuse me, I said, do you know you're writing my name? Maybe I should have said it differently. She grabbed her stuff, grabbed her package, and ran like hell.
Really?
Then I found out from a woman I know in Ardsley.
Where are you in Westport?
And said I was in Bridgeport. A woman who I know in town said, an elderly woman, I meet her in the supermarket once in a while. She said, you know, Renee, I met somebody at a dinner party. Her husband was a doctor, head of the department in Mount Sinai. They had a doctor's party or something. And I met someone at a dinner party in New Rochelle with your name. I said, did you tell the woman that she had my name? Because she ran from me once. I said, it must have been the same woman. She said, well, I did say it, but she was kind of busy and it didn't come. She said, but you really should try to get in touch with her. I said, well, she hung up on me once before. I mean, why should she come up to me now? But that's a possibility. I know that Renee Trell, the wife of Max or someone of these, lives in. Whose wife is she? I don't know. That's another story.
She's your alternate story.
Who's the Trell that's in Florida?
Elaine.
That's John and Elaine.
Elaine.
John.
John's daughter.
John and Bertie's daughter.
John is one of his
daughter. That was the oldest brother.
John, Elaine.
That was screwed it up. They gave each other the same name.
It was an adopted daughter.
Elaine.
An adopted daughter.
Don't they have relatives in California, too?
That's his grandma. That's his sister, and that's her side. But his sister
is grandma's side.
She never showed up.
My sister?
Easy come, easy go. I haven't seen her in 50 years.
We're only 49.
Whatever.
Who is in California? My sister said that she'd seen the license plates with Trell on it. And one was in front of a restaurant, she said, and she has a lot of nerve. So she's waited until someone, you know, would come out. She's been known.
The advertising business, his name was Trell.
Gail Trell
was married to
Marie Pogorski's
son.
There's the Pogorskis again.
How can
they have a Trell name?
Yeah.
They're married to Pogorski, whatever.
Is she the Trell? Norman Trell.
Her husband was Norman.
That's it.
And she was the one who was in the paper. She's
the
vice president.
She was the vice president of CBS. Yeah. She lived on 11 Riverside.
Right. Gail Trell.
Even Trell is the vice president.
We don't know.
She's married twice already.
Who is she married to?
Norman.
Now, who is Norman?
They go on the side.
Norman goes on the side with Gail.
Who is Norman Trell?
We have to find out. That's
because there is a Renee Trell and
there is
a Gail Trell.
I saw Renee Trell, maybe Gail Trell's daughter.
Gail Trell keeps her name. She kept that name.
She used her name, professionally when
she worked
for CBS.
No,
she
married
in
Nashville.
She used it because it was short.
What,
Grandpa?
I'm trying to think which post office I saw a picture of Trell.
Everything goes to Edgar.
Everything goes to Edgar.
had come from Kishinev. Then they went to Odessa. Kishinev was on the Hungarian border. She bakes and cooks Hungarian.
You got any recipes?
Where
from Germany.
Where was your father born? Russia?
In Russia.
Do you know the town in Russia?
No, he doesn't.
Well, wait a minute. You don't have any idea?
How can you know? He wasn't even born.
My birth certificate only says that my father was born in Russia.
That's all. It doesn't
say
where.
Did they give the time when he came to the United States?
Why?
Why didn't they like her?
Why didn't the Trell family like your mother?
I don't know. Okay. He died before I was born, so she never told me. I never found out until later.
Yeah.
Improvements. Improvements. Because every time he went to the hospital, he says, he's improving, and he died of improvement.
He died of improvement.
You're waking up!
Tuberculosis.
TB.
Right, too bad. And they sent him up here to some place in the Catskills.
Danbury.
There was some place that took care of
him. Rosinger's was originally a tuberculosis place.
You're kidding.
Sound that
place?
I don't know.
Oh, Liberty, I think it was. That's
right. Rosinger's was in Liberty.
My name is Max Trell.
Okay.
And I kept getting letters from Paris, France, from these girls, Max Trell, and my wife wanted to know who they were. So I took my uncle's last name, which was Kemp, and put it into my middle name, so it was Max Kemp Trell.
That's
so I just shortened it down.
What year, Dad?
47.
1947?
No, 47 A.D.
I married him at 33.
That's B.C.
Before children.
Right.
Well, that was kosher. I was in the store, and a woman comes in, and she says, "Is this Max Trell's place?" And I said, "Yes." So she says, "I used to go with Max."
Dirty laundry.
She said, "We met in Paris." So he had another life. I said, "I know that he was in Nicaragua." But what was he doing in Paris, you know? And then he came out and told me. I went back and I said, "Someone said to you she met you in Paris."
I said, "She's full of crap."
He said it in French.
On top of that, you mentioned a picture, the Nick North, the detective.
Nick and Nora.
The thin man.
And their dog.
Yeah.
Ask.
the scriptwriter was Max Trell. And everybody came and said, "Are you Max Trell?" Yeah. And, and another time, I had a book, The Voyage of Alexander Dumas or something like that, and it was a leather-bound book, and I had my name in gold.
Who gave you that book?
I don't know.
I did!
Are you Max Trell? I said, "Yeah, I'm Max Trell. Did you write the book?" I think, I don't know whether I said yes or no, but I didn't bother.
You autographed it.
Well, that's okay.
In his heydays, he was heavy. I mean, he looked just like Jackie Gleason.
He was heavy, right?
Oh, yeah.
And when we'd go through the toll on the Merritt Parkway, and they salute him. It goes through.
He wouldn't pay? No. He didn't pay?
No, no, they did.
Testing went too. They wouldn't pay? He didn't pay?
No, I said. Not only that, we were on 42nd Street, and I went into the store to buy a necktie.
Oh, yeah.
And nobody would wait on me. They all ran in
there. They all got excited.
Started giggling.
They were talking.
What the hell's the matter? One, I heard one girl say, "There's Jackie Gleason, there's Jackie Gleason,
there's Jackie Gleason."
And I don't walk down the store.
That's weird.
Jane
Meadows.
June Taylor.
June Taylor.
June Taylor.
June Taylor.
That's what we said, Stephen.
I said Jane Taylor.
No, I said June.
Jane Meadows.
And Jane who?
They just married
this female. You're going too fast.
You're going
too
fast.
Okay,
no.
Tell me about Nicaragua.
He's dead.
Eddie, you were in Europe, weren't you?
You were in Nicaragua?
No,
Eddie
was around during World War One. I mean, two.
You were in Italy.
Was that the War of 1812?
1811.
You were there a year early.
That's why they had the war.
The big war.
W2,
right.
Fighting anybody. I said, "Yeah, my mother and father."
Right?
You ran away from this.
Oh, you ran away?
Why did you go into the
ring?
I don't know.
You want hot oatmeal.
I needed a pair of shoes. And I knew I'd get them for nothing if I joined the parade.
They wouldn't be your size.
And they were the wrong size,
right.
Anyhow.
Uncle Sam said, I want you.
Some guy pointing at me on a poster.
What Jewish boy
went into the ring?
Wonderful.
My father was a host. How old were you in 1928? How old? Is that on? When you went into the army? 21. My father. Your mother had a summer. He was 21 when he went in. No, Dad. So what year were you born? He was younger. I was 18.
Anybody want to order a wedding?
I was in a war. Holy,
you want to see what's going on?
Look at Grandpa.
coming back.
You were half shot. Come on, I got a Korean War right here.
I have a bicycle scar right here.
I shaved last week.
No. Really?
I
had
a shaving scar myself.
You want to hear war stories? I got war stories.
Battery. Battery.
Bob it. Oh, so turn it off.
Bob it.
Let's see your forehand, Brian. Thank you.
They're unbelievable.
Yeah, put it up.
With an 800, do you have an 800 number?
I have the menu. The menu is one. Really?
Okay, everyone, this is our first morning here. We're already settled in. We had one great night, which you've seen the tapes of already. And this is the front of the main building. This is the Bilhan Estate we're looking at. And to the right there, that's a parking lot for valet cars. Now, if you'll notice, there are two cars in the parking lot. One is Uncle Franklin's, one is mine. Because we don't mess around. This is the front of the building with the lovely grounds. And there, we're coming to the library building. That's where we're all staying. All the important people are staying. And that's the library. No books. We're inside the main house, and this is one of the dining rooms featured in a Connecticut magazine. And you can see this lovely view we have outside of the water. Beautiful. It's a little hazy out today.
Thank you.
Oh, it's nice in here.
It's
this is breakfast.
And everyone's here yet. We're waiting.
Can Grandma and Grandpa been up?
Grandpa. I met Dad outside in the parking lot. I said, Dad, how many times you walk around? He said, 5. I said, what are you going for, 20? It's very bright in here. As you can see, the Franklin Trails have their shades on.
She has a bad ankle, what? Butter?
No.
Yeah, we'll make it melt.
And pepper. Well, I just see it's getting hot.
Yeah. Is it getting hot?
Can you feel the heat? Well, let me do more.
Should start. We can push around.
Butter. And I'm going to make this butter melt.
Yeah.
Okay. By putting more salt and salt.
Move the glass.
Will you see if it's getting hot?
Don't interrupt.
Hot? Hot? Is it getting hot?
No. More on?
Okay, well, now see if it's getting hot.
Hey, Dad! Wave! Tell him to wave, Robert.
What?
Okay, he's got it.
He's got everybody photographing everybody else. Yeah, yeah.
Julie, where's your camera?
I'm getting it.
It's in the room?
Yeah.
Why didn't you bring it down?
Ready?
Who's Brian?
I don't
know.
I don't know.
Okay, that's great. Thanks,
Dr. Mollie. I'll see him. Kill him.
Steve, stop.